doing today. Today we are going to study about our next chapter, food and health. This is for class 5, like you have in your chapters and in your book. And this is the lesson 4th of your chapter. Before we start the chapter, food and health, I would like to explain what is food. We eat food every day. There is necessary of our food. The most important thing in our life, in human life, is food, shelter and clothes. Without shelter, we cannot live. Without clothes, we cannot live. And without food, obviously, we cannot live. We need food in every interval of time. Say we have to eat food, carbohydrates or rice or wheat, in every 3 hours, because our food takes time to digest. So, starting this chapter, I would like to tell, what is food? What do you understand by food? Why do we eat food? What is the necessary of food in our life? Anything that gives us energy, food gives us energy to grow. You have seen a small baby being born. After being born, like you grow from an infant to a child, from a child to a teenager, from a teenager to an adult, and similarly from an adult to an old person. So, to keep us healthy is food. Whatever we eat or however we grow, from being a tall, from being a small baby to a tall person, we need food. This food, it gives us energy, and it also helps in multiplying the cell that our body needs. We do rigorous activities. We do many activities every day. It is not that we just keep quiet and don't do. We have lots of many things. See, human beings are social animals. So just because human beings are social animals, you have to do lots and lots of activity. From studying, from doing tiny little things, from moving here and there. Even when a child is born, he is taught to move. He is taught to make his first steps. Now, comes under our 3 basic needs, like I have already said. Now, while studying food, there are different types of food. Food that we cook and eat in our home. Food that we get easily. Food that we buy from the market. Now, everything is not available easily, not even food. Food we eat, they are raw foods, they are cooked foods, they are uncooked foods, like fruits and vegetables. Some of the fruits and vegetables we can eat it easily without getting cooked, like fruits, apples, mango, but still they need to be grown, they need to be sown. Now, cooked foods like rice, wheat or vegetables, whatever you need to cook, that cannot be eaten raw, just because while cultivation of food, because food like vegetables or anything, cereals, crops, they also need to be cultivated, and while being cultivated there are lots of different bacteria and germs and insects that are itself in the food, and however cooking of food helps to kill the bacteria as well as it helps our body, our stomach to get digested very easily. Now, exercise and yoga. It is not only that only food, consumption of food does the wonders, does magic. No, we need to do exercises and yoga. Why do we need to do exercises and yoga? We need to do exercises and yoga because it keeps our mind and body active and fresh. If you don't do exercise, you'll feel very lazy and our body will not function properly. You can see that some of the old people who cannot function their bodies, or even some of the children or some people they cannot function their body properly because they are born with different defects or lacking of many nutrients that is there. Now, while studying the chapter, you can see in your book that there are nutrients in food. What are nutrients? The essential components that we get after consuming from food is known as nutrients. Now, it is not that only we eat food. Why do we actually eat food? Because we need nutrients. because whatever we eat, food that is digested in our stomach within 2 to 3 hours, and it comes out from our intestine. There are different bodily functions. It is not only that food does the magic. No, our body requires all these nutrients, proteins, carbohydrates. Now, what are these nutrients? You can say carbohydrate, fats, then vitamins, minerals. There are different things. Now, first we are going to study about carbohydrate. What is carbohydrate? Now, all of us eat rice, wheat. We all eat. Around the world, every people eat rice or wheat, because without all these are the staple food. Without this food, we do not function our body nicely. When we do not function our body nicely, we cannot function our work nicely. Mind is not stable, or we become weak. Many of the children, you people, or even us, whoever, who don't consume food properly, they have lots of defects, and they become sick, or sometimes they become ill. They cannot function it nicely. So carbohydrates, what are carbohydrates? Why do we need carbohydrates? We need carbohydrates because it is an energy giving food, and when it gives energy, it gives nutrients. Like, what things we can get from carbohydrates? From what are the things that can be gained from carbohydrates? Like, what we get? Potassium, right? Starch, bread, these all different food that we eat, that from that we get carbohydrates, like potatoes, rice. Now, have you ever experienced yourself that when you don't eat rice or wheat, your staple food, the main food that you eat, we eat twice a day, maybe in the afternoon you eat rice, or in the night dinner time, lunch and dinner you eat, or that is substituted with rice or chapati or stuff. When we eat this food, that gives us energy. It is stored in our body. If you see your body, it's stored in our body. And when it is stored in our body, it helps to function nicely. Then the second one, let's come to fats. What is fat? And how? What are the things that gives us fat? Milk, butter, oil, cheese, ghee, nuts. All of us like milk. Well, some of them don't like milk also. Butter and bread is very as simple as that. Then cheese, very yummy. Ghee and nuts. Nuts and ghee are very important because it helps some. It is also said that some of the children or some these foods makes you help intelligent, to be intelligent. So these fats helps to protect organs, your heart, your kidneys. These we do not know what exactly that how it is helping, but somewhere or the other, indirectly or directly, this food helps us doing magic, helps us in giving energy and also saving us. Then there are two types of fat, like you have seen or known somewhere. There are two types of fat. One is good fat and one is bad fat. What is good fat, and from what are the things, what are the foods that we eat that we get good fats? Avocados are there, omega-3 fatty acids are there. These helps to protect your heart. Your heart is one of the most fragile organ. Among others, yes, of course. Now, this fragile organ helps to pump the blood. And you can see some of the people have high cholesterol or high heartbeat and all. If your heart stays good, you stay young forever. And then you have what? Then you have bad fats. What are the bad fats? The bad fats are, you have this problem like vein problem. Some are very healthy, and some have heart issues, clogged arteries, or like blood pressure high, and all these things are there. So this is why you need to have it nice. Okay, now continuing. After, then there is minerals. What are minerals? These are required in small quantities. Okay, our body requires a small quantity of minerals, in which this helps in formation of blood and building our bones, like formation of blood, purifying the blood and building the bones and all. We require minerals and teeth. We all know that calcium is one of the important components that required in building of the bones as well as making our teeth strong. Understood? And calcium can be gained from milk products and so on. And the These helps in fighting diseases also known, these are also known as protective nutrients. Now, minerals are what many a times we have flu, we have common cold, and many such diseases, sometimes we notice that without any medications, it goes on just away. So when this goes on just away, how is it possible? Because we have such foods that gives us energy, that gives us mineral, that is how it forms protective. This is how our body helps to fight against those diseases without any medications, without any medicines and so on. Then water and roughage, what are there? Our body has 70. We all have studied in our junior class. We also know that our body and our earth is consisted of 70% of water, because water is very important for us. Without water we cannot survive. So when we require water, water is in our blood. Our whole body is water. We can find out water by sweating. Our water comes out in pure blood. Water helps also to purify the impurities of our blood and of our body, comes throughout urine as well as sweats. Now, roughage. What is roughage? Roughage is very, very important. It is fibrous indigestible material we get from plants, that is rice, cabbage, banana, guava, etc. It helps to digest our food. Understood? It is one of the most important components. Then let's come to protein. Protein is very, very important for our body. It helps in growing. Helps proteins. Proteins helps to repair our muscles, and it helps to grow our body. Those children, small children, like you children, when you are growing at this age, when you are entering teenage, when your body is rapidly growing, that is the time when you require proteins in large amounts. Sportsperson who do rigorous exercise and activities, and even working people, laborers, they require much protein, and sometimes because of the poverty they do not get enough food. That is when you can see that their bodies are becoming weaker and weaker every day, and they are suffering through various diseases. Now, we have already studied about this protein. How, from what are the different things that we get proteins? We get proteins from meat, chicken, mutton, egg, milk, spinach, fruits and vegetables. That is how we get proteins from. Now, vitamins. What are vitamins? Vitamins are important nutrients that helps in maintaining good health. Whatever we eat, fruit. Vitamin A can be gained from carrots, papaya, mango, rice, butter, egg, yolk, milk and all green and leafy vegetables. Vitamin B can be also gained from green leafy vegetables, milk, cereals and peas. Vitamin C is one of the most important during this time, that can be gained from lemon, amla, tomatoes, spinach and strawberries as well. Vitamin D, that is milk, cheese, curd, egg, and sunlight is also one of the most important components from where we can get vitamin D. Then iron. What are iron? Iron helps in the formation of blood platelets. Sometimes when we have deficiency of blood, like we say, khoon ki, that is when we can get from pomegranate, apple, beetroot and all, dried fruit, nuts and all these things. Now, iodine we get from salt as well as green vegetables, fishes and prawns. Seafoods are one of the most important components from where we get iron. And then there is calcium. Calcium helps in formation of our bones as well as teeth.